the ratio of accelerating potential to accelerate a proton and an alpha particle to have the same de Broglie's wavelength associated with them. Remember, de Broglie's wavelength is given by formula lambda equal to h by p. And here, when alpha particle and proton they are accelerated, they acquire the same de Broglie's wavelength, means lambda for alpha particle, it must be same as that of lambda, that is de Broglie's wavelength for proton. And this is possible as per this equation, that is equation 1. When lambda is same, it means momentum p must be same, means momentum for proton, it must be same as that of momentum for alpha particle, and say it is equal to p. Say it is equal to what? P. We know that whenever charged particles are accelerated through certain potential difference, then they acquire potential energy. And the potential energy acquired by any charged particle, whenever they are accelerated through certain potential difference, it must be equal to kinetic energy of charged particle. Now, what is potential energy of charged particle? Potential energy of charged particle is charge on a given charged particle into potential difference through which they are accelerated. And their kinetic energy, we know the formula for kinetic energy, half m into what? V square. Half m into V square. Remember here this capital V represent potential difference and this V represent what? The velocity. So, let us multiply this by m and divide it by m. So, in the numerator, we are having m into m means it is m square. See here, qv is equal to m square v square divided by 2m. But we know what is momentum p is equal to m into v. Therefore, p square is equal to m square v square. Therefore, this equation will become qv is equal to p square divided by 2m, or p square is equal to 2mq into v. 2mq into v. But we know that momentum is same both for proton and for alpha particle, means p is same. It means automatically this m into q into v is same. So what we can write? P for alpha particle upon p for momentum, p square is equal to 2m charge on alpha particle into v for alpha particle divided by 2 into here alpha particle mass, mass of proton into charge on proton into velocity of what? Proton. So these two get cancelled with these two, or we can say here p alpha square on p proton square. P is same, it means here they get cancelled. So we are having mass on proton into charge on proton into velocity of proton is equal to mass on alpha particle into charge on alpha particle into what? Velocity of alpha particle. So let us take the ratio. Ratio upon velocity of proton upon velocity of alpha particle when they are accelerated is equal to mass on alpha particle into charge on alpha particle divided by mass on proton into charge on proton. And here what is mass of alpha particle given? Mass of alpha particle is what? 4 times what? Mass on proton into charge on alpha particle. What is charge on alpha particle? It is 2 times charge on proton divided by mass of proton into charge of proton. So mass of proton, charge on proton get cancelled, and therefore we are having velocity of proton upon velocity of alpha particle is equal to 4 into 2, that is equal to 8, that is equal to 8. So 8 divided by 1. So which option is correct for this question? It is option B.